safe handling of hazardous medicines at home, giving injectable medicine by mouth. This video will show you how to prepare and give injectable hazardous medicine safely by mouth. Always follow these safe handling methods to provide the best protection for you and your family during your child's treatment. Sometimes people who care for patients must handle hazardous medicines. Hazardous medicines can treat a variety of medical conditions. For instance, chemotherapy treats cancer, and immunosuppressants prevent organ rejection after a transplant. Ask your healthcare provider if your child's medicine requires safe handling. Hazardous medicines can damage healthy cells, so they must be handled safely. The risk of harm from handling hazardous medicines is small, but it's still a good idea to avoid direct contact with them. This includes not tasting your child's medicine, and if possible, avoid contact with hazardous medicines if you are pregnant or breastfeeding. You will need to gather certain supplies and take careful steps when setting up your work area. Your child's healthcare provider will help you make a list of the supplies you will need. You can buy these materials at a grocery or drugstore. To handle your child's hazardous medicine at home, choose an uncluttered counter or table away from windows, fans, vents, areas where you prepare food, and where children and pets play. Depending on how you prepare your child's medicine, your supplies may include paper towels or a disposable absorbent plastic-backed mat to contain any spills, a disposable gown to protect you and your clothing, a disposable mask, gloves to minimize direct contact with the medicine. To prepare injectable medicine to be given by mouth, you will need a vial containing the medicine, syringes to draw up medicine from the vial, a vial access device, a spike, to allow safe removal of medicine from the vial, a container with a lid or plastic bag to dispose of the syringe, vial, and spike, a suitable drink, and a labeled container to place any unused mixed medicine. A medicine cup or a labeled cup used only for giving the medicine. Always prepare the medicine right before your child will take it. Before you begin, wash your hands with soap and water. Put on your gloves and place paper towels or a disposable absorbent plastic backed mat over the counter surface. You are now ready to handle your child's medicine. Put on your gown and mask. To give the injectable medicine by mouth, you can dilute it in the syringe or mix it with the drink. Only some medicines can be mixed with liquids. Your child's healthcare provider will tell you if you can do this with your child's medicine. Ask your healthcare provider which drink is suitable to mix with the medicine. Remove the plastic cap from the vial and place the vial upright on the counter. Remove the vial spike from its packaging. Take off the protective cover on the spike. Making sure the vial is upright, align the spike with the center of the vial closure. Keep the spike straight and push down firmly into the vial until the spike passes through the rubber stopper and the plastic skirt snaps onto the vial. Remove the syringe from its packaging. Attach the syringe to the top of the vial spike by pushing and twisting until secure. Turn the vial upside down and pull back the syringe plunger slowly to draw out the required dose. Your child's healthcare provider will tell you the required dose. If you need to push medicine back into the vial, turn the vial upright before doing so. Remove the syringe from the vial spike. You are now ready to mix the medicine. To give the injectable medicine by mouth, you can dilute it in the syringe or mix it with the drink. To dilute it in the syringe, draw some of the drink into the syringe with the medicine and give it to your child. Whatever amount of medicine your child needs, you will need to add at least an equal amount of the drink to improve how the medicine tastes. Place the syringe into your child's mouth and slowly push the plunger to release the medicine. If your child is unable to take their medicine from a syringe, you can dilute it with the drink in the cup instead. Push the medicine from the syringe into the cup with the drink. Stir to mix it, and give the medicine cup to your child to drink. Make sure they finish all the liquid in the cup. You may also give them more of the drink afterwards. Speak to your healthcare provider if your child is having trouble taking the medicine. Once you are done, throw the syringe into a container for disposal. You will use a new syringe every time you prepare a dose. The vial spike can remain in the medicine vial and can be used for other doses. Store the vial upright in a cool, dry place, protected from light. Use a new vial spike for each new medicine vial that you use. and discard the empty medicine vial and used vial spikes into the disposal container. Hazardous medicines should be handled safely. It's important to carefully handle the cleanup of the supplies and work area and to dispose of waste properly. All disposable items that have been in contact with the hazardous medicines, such as the used paper towels and gloves, must go into a designated plastic waste bag or container. Dispose of this plastic bag at a hazardous waste depot. You may wash and reuse some of your supplies, but take care not to rinse them in the kitchen sink over other dishes or utensils. If you are reusing an item, such as the medicine cup, rinse with warm soapy water and let it air dry. Clean the sink after washing your supplies. Always store hazardous medicines away from children and pets. If stored at room temperature, place them in a locked box away from moisture and direct sunlight and in a cool, dry place. If the medicine needs refrigeration, place it in a separate container at the back of the fridge. Return the medicine to the locked box or fridge after each use. Do not keep any medicine in your purse, knapsack, or diaper bag. Some of the medicine may be present in your child's vomit, urine, and stool. It is important to handle these safely as well. When changing your child's diaper, wear disposable gloves and place diapers in a separate sealed plastic bag before disposal. If your child is toilet trained, have your child close the lid and flush twice after using the toilet, and then have them wash their hands. If your child's clothing or sheets are soiled with vomit, urine, or stool, wash them separately from other laundry. If you can't wash them right away, place them in a sealed plastic bag and set them aside. Once you are all finished, wash your hands. Remember these key tips for safe handling of hazardous medicines at home. If possible, avoid contact with hazardous medicines if you are pregnant or breastfeeding. Wash your hands before and after handling hazardous medicines. Wear gloves when handling hazardous medicine tablets, capsules, or liquids. Properly clean, dispose, or store the equipment and hazardous medicine. For more information on these tips, speak to your healthcare provider.